which was purchasing 4 complete sets of structural firefighting turnout gear. Yay. I know you guys can probably use them. Does anybody have any questions about that item? Item number 7, Chief Blair's item. Approve the renewal of Code Red, Code Red Weather Warning, and Integrated Public Alert Warning Systems in an amount not to exceed $12,500.
Chief?
Yeah.
How is this? I know that this
had the calls, right?
That in the text messages, too.
On the text.
Yeah, it's actually twofold.
Oh, yeah, right.
There can be a mobile app that's downloaded, as well as alert systems that are currently in place. For each Amber Alerts and what have you, so it's a multifaceted system.
So how has this worked? I mean, has it worked well from your experience so far? Or?
Absolutely. We just had a missing child recovered,
yes.
Autistic child. Yeah, it works out really well for us. Yeah.
Okay. Chair.
Mr. Mayor.
Just one question, Chief. Chief, this is the unlimited package, correct?
That's correct.
The first year we had a subscribe to it. It was limited, and the data was limited, and then we found out that for a small additional cost, we could go unlimited, which allowed us to use it for a lot more options.
That's correct. Yeah, we've expanded from just the weather side
right.
to a little bit further areas in this. Again, it's multifaceted. There's many things you can do with it. It's very, very user-friendly. It's really quick. You can get out to millions of users almost immediately, so it's a really valuable tool for us that we've used in the past.
Almost like Amber Alert.
Absolutely.
I noticed that some money from general fund is, now is this forfeiture dollars that we're using towards this?
Yeah, I saw that, it was a little bit different. It comes from two things. We did an audit when I started taking over the chief spot. We found money from JAG 2014, which we funded a large portion of it, and the rest of it's coming from the police department IT budget.
IT budget.
So, yes, the police department. So.
That can't be that much. It was the chief, I didn't know it was $600.
Yeah, it's 11,862 from the JAG, and then only 638 from
the IT budget.
From our IT department.
Thank you.
I think I asked this before, though, but is this the type of thing that we can use, like if there's a water main break, that's a warning, isn't it? That we should need, can't we notify a certain stretch of street or something
it's,
like that?
Yeah, it's geographically
mm-hmm.
it's set up to whatever parameters you want. It could be a block,
right.
Could be a mile, could be whatever
right.
you want.
So like downed wires, water main breaks, all that.
That's the reason behind the system that
okay.
we can utilize it in that way.
Okay.
Is it being utilized in that way now though, or just strictly for like, you know,
You know, if we had some sort of a mass casualty incident, our active shooter
type thing,
we had
right,
on the block,
yeah.
Right. Rough Wick Road, we've used it for that, and the missing children, we
okay.
utilized it.
I think we've used it a couple times for like hazardous spills where we've communicated for people to stay away from the area.
Okay.
Now, I don't think we've used it to the full potential, but I think we're getting better.
Okay, item number 10 is the agreement between the city of Taylor and Fish and Lumps for the San Antonio Forest. Does anybody have any questions for that? So we're all pretty used to that one, right? Item number 11.
Madam Chair, can we go back to 10
yeah.
for a minute? Jason pointed this out earlier. I just want to make everybody aware that technically we're not supposed to have lease agreements with no charge. We have typically done that for Fish and Lumps, but I just want to make sure everybody's aware that we're proposing to keep it the same, but if anybody has any objection, let us know.
Okay.
Oh, I thought he was learning.
Or make it $1 or something that, yeah.
That's, you're in
okay.
my
Oh, okay.
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 All right, item number 11 is to approve the purchase of the for the water department operating supplies, not to exceed $62,500. Okay.
11 through is water and 17, 18 is sewer.
Yeah. Okay. All right, well, let's go through the questions first and then we can talk about sewer and consent here. So, does anybody have questions on 11, which is the water department operating supplies? Okay, how about number 12, which is the purchase for water department fees and license account in the amount not to exceed $18,000? Okay, So item number 13, then, any questions for the water department property restoration account? In an amount not to exceed $91,000.
Sure. I noticed, so one of the line items for this, for the vendors, under Fiore Enterprises LLC for $35,000. That, what type of service will be contracting from them? Is it concrete work or?
Yeah, wherever we have water main break into the road or anything that affects the concrete, Fiore comes in and repairs it. We provide them a list and they come in.
Okay. Now, is this amount consistent with the last year's?
Yeah, I think all these amounts were consistent with last year's. These are all from 11 to 18, we believe, all blanket purchase orders.
So are we going to call them every time and every time, or are we going to go to one of the two contractors to see the pricing and see if there's a better pricing? Because I know we got unit pricing and a lot of stuff.
Yeah, we did, but they're a little bit on the concrete. I think the last, what you're talking about is like manhole rebuilds and things like that where it's some different pricing.
Yeah, but, yeah, I mean, that could be some of the water main breaks is, you know, no manholes and stuff.
Yeah, we mostly just have the concrete repairs.
So that's a general question. And how did you come up with all of each individual one of these vendors?
From the past. The finance department pretty much put together from the same purchase orders that we had in the previous years.
Okay. Any other questions on 13? Okay, so 14 is a motion to approve the purchase and service for the water department equipment rental and repairs account. And that's an amount not to exceed $11,000. And again, that's just two vendors, Michigan Cat and Granger.
Does the city of Taylor, do we do business with Alta supplies? I know that we've...
What, rental?
Your rentals and things of that nature.
We do. We just, they were partially the vendor for the Windrow turn.
Oh, okay.
So that was $400,000.
Do we have that over here?
Excuse me?
Is that there?
Yes. We turned everything in a day and a half. Everything that needed to be turned.
Okay. Any more questions on 14? 15 is approve the purchase and services for the water department repair and maintenance account in the amount not to exceed $25,000. Any questions? Okay, number 16 is a motion to approve the purchase and service for the water department operating supplies account in an amount not to exceed $125,000. How does that differ from number 11? Because that's both operating supplies account. I'm just curious there. And that's not the one you asked about? I know you said Alta.
Yeah,
Alta.
I don't know why it would be different, but I know Aetna is solely, you know, pipe and fittings and stuff.
It's oh, yeah, Aetna's.
There's no service like Michigan Cat would be.
Correct. Aetna's more for parts, water clamps, fire hydrants, pipe.
So there was
so what is 11
had 18,000 for Aetna supplies and 16 had 125. So I guess I'm not sure why they're separated.
Right.
Two
different
accounts.
Yeah, that's what it is.
Is it?
Yes.
557, 516. Is there going to be a word issue on one of these motions? I don't have the back of that.
Well, they both say water department operating supplies, I guess.
Yeah.
This is the
accounts might be different, but I'm just asking what's the difference.
Yes, it's actually, that's what it is. It's two different sub-departments. You know, the water department has, I think, three or four sub-departments, which is billing, customer service, transmission. That's what it is when you see a different, third segment is your, that's what it is, same account name, but different sub-department.
Okay.
I would think that 18,000 was a service because that's smaller.
A smaller amount.
You buy things for a water meter when you're replacing water meters and stuff, plumbing parts for that and so on.
Yeah,
that's what I would assume.
That's the bigger of the two. Okay. Any other questions on that? Item 17. Item number 17 is to approve the purchase for sewer equipment rental and repairs in an amount not to exceed $15,000. No questions? Item number 18 is to approve the purchase and service again for sewer operating supplies in an amount not to exceed $9,000. Okay. Any questions there?